Welcome to SPR IAS Academy. ComeOnIndia.com is our website. In this video lecture, we are going to see about the President of India Part 2. In the first part regarding the President of India, we have covered topics like how the President is elected, what is the counting process, what is the qualification required to become the President, what are the terms of tenure associated with him, what is the procedure if the presidential office remains vacant. Kindly watch that video for previous information regarding the President of India. Now in this article we will discuss about the powers given to the President of India in detail. The President of India has the wide array of powers, and it is classified mainly into four types. The first one is about the administrative powers, and second is about the legislative powers associated with the governance, and third one is about the military powers, and the fourth one is about the judiciary. We will discuss all these powers in a detailed manner as follows. The first topic that we are going to discuss about is executive powers of the President. At first, all the executive actions that Government of India is making is formally take place under the name of President. Apart from that, the President can specify and make the rules regarding the instrument of instructions related to the process so it can be authenticated. The next point that we are going to discuss about is most important because it is about the appointment power of the President. That is, the President appoints the Prime Minister and the other Council of Ministers. Apart from that, the President also appoints the Attorney General, and he decides its remuneration. Remember here, the Attorney General holds the office under the pressure of the President. There is no removal procedure for him to be removed from the office. That is, if the President decides to remove the Attorney General, he can do it. Apart from that, the President also appoints the Governor of the state. Governor of the state is appointed by the President of India. He appoints the Chief Election Commissioner. He appoints the Member of Finance Commission and the Chief of the Finance Commission, etc. Apart from the above said statement, President has the power to establish the commission to check the conditions of SC, ST and the other backward communities. He will get the report from these commissions, and it is laid upon the Parliament on behalf of him. President has the power to appoint the Interstate Council. Remember, President has the power to appoint the Interstate Council to promote the relation between the center and state. Now we will discuss about the administration powers given to the President. President directly administers the union territories with the help of administrators appointed by him. Apart from this, he is able to declare the area as a scheduled area for tribes on behalf of their interest. Though the President have a lot of powers, he is advised by the Prime Minister with the Council of Ministers. The President's action is bound upon the instructions given by the Prime Ministers along with the Council of Ministers. The President has the power to get the instructions from any minister. Apart from that, if there is any requirement for him, he will ask the Prime Minister to submit the detailed report on the issue. The President can seek advice from the Prime Minister on the administration of Union and the affairs related to it. Now we will discuss briefly about the legislative powers associated with the President. The President is able to summon and prorogue the Parliament when it is not in session. The second important thing about the legislative power associated with him is about the joint sitting. Article 108 of the Indian Constitution enables the President of India to call for the joint sitting of both the houses if the bill or issue does not come to the conclusion. The next important point associated with the legislative power is about addressing the session. President will address the newly elected Parliament, or he will begin his address with the starting of the session. The next important power of the President is nomination facility. That is, the President is able to nominate the members to Rajya Sabha. He is able to represent the nominated members, that is 12 members can be nominated by the President. In that, the two numbers is about the Anglo-Indian community. If he feels the Anglo-Indian community is not adequately represented in the Parliament, he is able to nominate two members from the Anglo-Indian community to the Rajya Sabha. The most important thing with the President is, if any bill passed by both the houses cannot become an act without the approval of the President. Now we will discuss with the financial powers associated with the President. The first thing is money bill. The money bill can be introduced in the Parliament only with the prior consent from the President. Without consent of the President, money bill cannot be implemented. And other fact lies with the money bill is, it is introduced in the Lok Sabha only. We cannot introduce money bill in the Rajya Sabha. The next important point is, all the demand for grant from the Consolidated Fund of India, that is Consolidated Fund of India is mentioned in the Article 266 of the Indian Constitution, cannot be acquired without the assent of President. Apart from that, President will authorize the government to get the money from the Contingency Fund of India in case if there is the any natural calamities. As we said earlier, in the executive power, President will appoint the head, that is Chief of the Finance Commission, and the members of the Finance Commission for every 5 years. Remember, the term period of the Finance Commission is every 5 years. After that, the President will once again will renew the Finance Commission. Here, the important thing is, Finance Commission is responsible for advising the government regarding the sharing of taxes, that is sharing of amount from the taxes to the center and state. Now we will discuss about the judicial powers given to the President. The President is responsible for the appointment, that is President is responsible for the appointment of Chief Justice of Supreme Court and the other judges of Supreme Court and the High Court. The most important thing associated with the judicial power is, he is able to get advice from the Supreme Court on behalf of the Article 143 of the Indian Constitution. Here the question will rise, whether the advice rendered by the Supreme Court is binding on the President or not. The answer to the question is, the advice rendered by the Supreme Court is not binding on the President. He will or he may take the advice to his consideration. Apart from that, the President is able to give pardon, respite, reprieve, remission of punishment, or suspend the punishment. Here we will see these things in detail as follows. The judicial power of the President will be discussed later in this video article while we come to the pardoning powers associated with the president according to the article 72. Now we will discuss about the emergency power associated with it. As we mentioned earlier, president is the supreme commander of our armed forces. He is able to declare war or internal emergency basis on these articles. The article 352 of the Indian Constitution says that it is for the national emergency, article 356 for the state emergency, and article 360 for the financial emergency. Remember, article 360 is important because it is for the financial emergency. So far it is implemented nil, that is, so far we didn't declare financial emergency in our country. Now we are going to discuss about the most important topic, that is veto powers associated with the president. The veto power is given to the president and it is supported on the grounds that the president, with the help of veto power, can able to protect his own office from the aggressive legislation. That is, with the help of veto power, president can able to protect his own office. How it will happen? We will see that. If a bill or legislation is passed by the members and if the president feels it is unconstitutional, remember the keyword is unconstitutional here, then the president may, with the help of veto power, can take the necessary action so that this unconstitutional act become entered in the state book, that is, it is to be authorized. The Indian president has the power, that is, he has three veto powers when compared to the American president, whereas he has four. The powers associated with the Indian president is absolute veto, suspensive veto, and the pocket veto. Before discussing these points, first we will know about when a bill becomes act. A bill becomes an act when president signs the bill after passing it by the two houses of the parliament. If a bill comes to the president, he under article 111 of the Indian Constitution, he is able to make three decisions. That is, the first one is he can give assent to the bill. Second one is he can withhold the bill, pass it by the houses. And third one is he can reject the amendments produced by the bill and he can return it to the houses. Suppose if the house once again passed that bill with the majority without making amendments, then the president have to sign that bill. First, we are going to discuss about the absolute veto. Absolute veto means the president does not take any action on the bill passed by the parliament. He generally takes this decision based on the two categories. First, if it is passed by the private member, he may withhold his decision for the betterment of the country. The next important point associated with this, the bill is, remember the concept is important here, the bill is passed by the parliament and it is came to the president's table for getting his assent. At the same time, if the cabinet resigns and the new government formed to ask the president not to withhold the assent, means president will not take any action regarding that bill. That is called as absolute veto. Now we will talk about the suspensive veto. The president exercises this veto when he once again gives the bill back to the parliament for reconsideration. That is, the parliament may accept his request whether it can pass the bill with or without the amendments. If the same bill is again passed by the parliament and it is given to the presidential assent, then president is bound to give assent to the bill. Here, The presidential veto in this case is breached by the parliament by passing the bill once again. However, it does not take place in the case of money bill, because the money bill can be introduced in the parliament by getting his prior assent from the president only. Now we will talk about pocket veto. In this method, the president does not take any decision regarding the bill. He can simply keep that bill without taking any decision, because the constitution does not give any time limit for passing the bill. Whereas in the case of America, the American constitution laid down time bound frame for passing the bill. Now we will discuss important thing about the ordinance making power. Here the president can promulgate the ordinance when a single house is not in session also, because a bill becomes come to the presidential desk after it get passed by the both the houses in case of Indian parliament. The ordinance making power, that is the ordinance issued by the president, has similar effect to the normal law. However, the criteria is whatever the ordinance may be given by the president, it has to be approved by the parliament within 6 weeks from its reassembly. Now we comes to the discussion of about the pardoning powers associated with the president. Earlier, while we talking about the judicial powers given to the president is able to pardon the persons who are earlier mentioned as a criminals by the Supreme Court or by the court material. The concept of giving pardoning power to the president is to keep the activities of the judicial errors open, and if there is a judicial error, the president may correct it. Article 72 of the Indian Constitution enables the president to pardon, commutate, remission, respect and reprieve the sentence. Now we will see all these in detail. The pardon. The pardon means it will remove the sentence and conviction on the person, and it relieves him completely from the charges against him. Whereas in the case of commutation, means it is substitution of the imprisonment from heavier form to lighter form. For an example, the death sentence of the person may converted into the rigorous imprisonment, whereas the same may turn into simple imprisonment. The remission means reducing the time period without changing the character of the judgment. Because for an example here, the rigorous imprisonment for the 2 years may be converted into rigorous imprisonment for the 1 year. Now we will discuss about the respite. Respite means changing the judgment into the lighter form while considering the disability of the person or pregnancy in case of the woman offender. Reprieve means stay of execution for a temporary period. Here, during this period, the person may get the verdict from the president what his judgment is supposed to undergo. That is, it is for the temporary stay of the judgment given by the court material. Now we will discuss about the constitutional position of the president. The president has to exercise his powers and functions with the aid and advice of the Council of Ministers. Remember, with the aid of Council of Ministers headed by the Prime Minister, based on their advice only, the president will act. Why this? Because the Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers is elected by the people, whereas the president is indirectly elected. It is important to say here is the president is the symbolic head and he is the nominal executive, whereas the real executive is the prime minister. President is the de jure executive, that is nominal. From the prelims point of view, the topic that we are going to discuss now is very important because president has no constitutional discretion. Remember, the highlight is the president have no constitutional discretion, but however he have some situational discretion. Now we will see what is the situational discretion possessed by the president in detail. President is empowered to appoint the prime minister when there is no party has a clear majority. Remember, he is empowered to appoint the prime minister in the state when no party has got the clear majority. He can dismiss the council of ministers when it failed to prove the confidence in Lok Sabha. Remember, he can able to dismiss the council of ministers when he cannot prove its confidence on the Lok Sabha. Here the question may arise like why not Rajya Sabha? Because it is a well known fact that Rajya Sabha is a permanent body and it cannot be dissolved, whereas Lok Sabha holds the period of 5-year tenure. Apart from that, the members that elected in the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people of India, so they are responsible to the people. The president is empowered to dissolve the Lok Sabha if the council of ministers had lost its majority. These are the situational discretions associated with the president of India. Thus, in this video lecture, we have covered about what are the powers associated with the president in detail. Earlier, we have covered president of India's how he is elected, what is qualifications required to participate in the presidential election, what are the terms of tenure, and how the counting process is done in the presidential election in detail as a separate video lecture. Thus, from SVRIS Academy, the President of India is covered under two video lectures. Kindly watch these two video lectures to know more information about the President of India. Thanks for watching this video lecture and all the best for your exam preparations.